Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the algorithm for all pair shortest path. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed about how you can do all pair shortest path problem. So in this lecture, we'll be going through that algorithm, how a computer will be doing it. So basically the formula, if you all remember, this was the formula which we have used. So basically we didn't use the formula, but we used our trick to solve it. And then we understood how the formula is there. The same thing which we are doing is what the formula is. Okay, so it will be checking from pair to pair, all types of combinations. So all possible combinations will be covered in this method. Okay, so this is the formula. If you ask me, a power k minus 1, I comma k plus a power k minus 1, k comma j, ik, kj. If you close these two, you'll be getting I comma j. Or you can even remember in this way. So if you ask me for this, let us assume a power a 1, 1 comma 3, it will be 1 comma 1 plus 1 comma 3, that's it. Okay, so that's how it works, guys. So I think if you are confused, please watch the previous lecture, guys, because in the previous lecture we have discussed about the method, how we are doing, and the trick that we are following. Okay, so algorithm for all pair shortest path, we'll be passing the cost A and N. So A is nothing but the matrix of the original graph, guys. Please remember that it's the matrix of the original graph. Okay, and the cost will be 1 to n and the 1 to j. So that is nothing but I comma j. Cost of I comma j will be computing, and that will be stored in an adjacency matrix. So that is the matrix which we are using from each and every step. A3, A2, A1, except A0, everything is nothing but the cost matrix. Or you can even assume that as the final matrix where you will be storing the cost. Both will work. Okay, so A of I comma j, you'll be storing the cost. So that's what I have just told you. So path of vertex I to j. Okay, so the cost of I comma I is always equal to 0. Please remember that, guys, because it's mandatory it will be 0. Please, so you can just skip some terms. So if it is a 3 into 3 matrix, you will be skipping 3 into 3 times. That is nothing but you can skip 9 steps, which I did. So even I did those 9 steps. So you can skip them because we already know this, right? So basically for our verification, I have just done them. Okay, so you will be starting from 1 to n. For of I equal to 1 to n, do. For of j equal to 1 to n, do. A of I comma j is equal to cost of I comma j. So if you remember, this is the cost matrix, right? So I substituted this inside A also. So the initial A value is this only. Okay, so that is what we are doing here. The first step is that only. After that, we are computing the formula based on our formula. So for of k equal to 0 to n, this is nothing but the k value. If you recall, we for 3 vertices, we told k equal to 1, k equal to 2 and k equal to 3. For k vertices, we are doing k times. For 3 vertices, we are going doing 3 times. So from k equal to 1 to n, that is nothing but 3 will be the number of vertices. So 1, 2, 3, we need to do it. So this loop will help us do this operation, whereas the inner two loops, I equal to 0 to n, j equal to 1 to n, we will be doing the operation that we wrote the formula here. Okay, so that formula is nothing but a of I comma j comma a of I comma, sorry, this is j comma k, sorry guys. Okay, j comma k plus a of j, okay, sorry, this is I comma k only. So I wrote this is the cost, and these are the other two terms. Okay, so in this way this works, guys. This is just the algorithm. So based on this single formula only, you will be writing the algorithm, guys. There is nothing much in this. Okay, so I hope everyone got a clear idea on this all pair shortest path. So please go through the example, guys, because this is an important problem, but it was not so much asked in the examinations, because in this chapter there are multiple important problems which are more important than this problem. Okay, so please be clear with the method so that if it comes, you can solve it. Okay, so I hope everyone got a clear idea on this algorithm. So at the end, the result will be in this way. You'll be getting a matrix with all the paths, all the combinations with their weights, so that you can identify which is the costliest, which is the path which is having the minimum cost path. Okay, so I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through optimal binary search tree. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.